Good day, night, evening, whatever time may be, ladies and gentlemen. This is Darth Chain. How y'all doing? Before we get started, I want you guys to know, just wait until the end of the video. I got a very special announcement at the end. But today we are going to be doing the graveyard portion of Spirit Veil. So sorry for the stuttering. Apparently my game didn't want to run smoothly. So I am working on getting the stutters out of the stream. Just bear with me for a second there. So this is right after our last video, the Veil Guardian. You come down this little hallway and you kill some spirits. Now this part is a little fun. You can kind of see where the spirits are falling. There's five different spots. There's two down by the river, one up top, and then one in the middle where we're standing right now, and one over by that gate right behind us. Now what's going to happen is after you take down the ghost here, there's going to be an event. Now this event spawns randomly around each of those five points. I'll probably put up a map here in a second to show you guys. And what it does is you gotta close spectral rifts. Now a bunch of enemies are going to spawn, but your main focus is getting on those rifts. You can see one spawn right there. You just need to get somebody in there for about 5 seconds or so to close it, and you got 4 minutes to do this. So you either fill up the bar or die in 4 minutes. Now you got 20 seconds to get into a spectral rift. The more people you have in it, obviously the quicker it gets closed. The game starts off really easy with just one, but then it'll go to about two. I've seen some group designate five people to the lower two and mid. I've seen then another five to the upper two and mid. And I've just seen everybody just kind of running around filling them as a entire group just to close them as quickly as possible. Again, there's five spots. This part's fairly easy. You want to attack the adds while you're in a spectral rift. You don't want to go out of your way to attack enemies. Mesmers can be nice, dropping portals to keep your team jumping back and forth. Blink to a drop a portal on the last one, blink to the next one, drop the exit, and you're good to go. Now, once you have completed all of them, most of the adds will disappear. You'll get your rewards, which are a couple magnetite shards and some other stuff. And now you get to go into the graveyard. Now, when you actually run to the graveyard, you get to see a glimpse of the spirit wall, but we're going to worry about that here in a second. What you're going to want to do in here is run straight back to this corner. Someone will pull the champion. You just take out the champion and then you just DPS the rest of the adds and then open up the spirit run, which we'll do here in a second. Just got to take out this champion and we're good. Again, this room's very easy. Don't worry about it too much. If you are working on legendary armor, there is a torch in this room. Someone just picked it up. It's a little blue flame on the wall. You need someone to carry it for this entire part, and you'll get an achievement for your legendary armor. Now we go on to the spirit run. I think that's what they call it. So you're going to see these spectral bombs again, and you're also going to see these ethereal barriers. Now, your range are going to want to stay inside of the spirit bomb. And I'm just going to call it spirit bomb because I can't remember the name right now. While the rest of your team goes after these ethereal barriers, you have to be quick on this. As you're doing this, there is a wall that is coming up behind you. If your team gets hit by it, it's an automatic down. Now, there's not too many walls, but as you get farther and farther, there's going to be more of these spirit bombs to take you down. Once you get past the second wall, you'll start seeing two. Again, here's two, and there's four walls in total. The last one has three of the spirit bombs you had to take down. Fairly easy stuff to take care of. Again, just leave your ranged on the spirit bombs and you're good. Now, this group chose to run past this guy. Usually groups will take him down. It's just an extra kill for stuff. And then we enter this room. So this room has a bunch of pressure plates you have to stand on to open up the gate to get to Gorseval. I'm going to stand on a pressure plate just right over here. I don't know where they all are. I found one here. There's one against the south wall, kind of hidden between two of the little house things they have back there. There's one in a tree or something like that. Just run around. If you don't know where they are, ask your teammates. They can help you out. Unfortunately, I kept on getting killed this run. I hated it. So, if you did bring the torch where that brazier is right now, you want to put it there and you will get your achievement. Other than that, you want to hit this chest here because they do give you ectoplasmic residue. You do also need that for your legendary armor. So there's going to be the one right there. There's going to be one up in this tree, right? Pillar right here. And then there's going to be one just under where we started the spirit run over here. When you do that, just type GG and get back to where Gorseval spawns. So there's me taking the death. There's Gorseval right there. And that will be the start of the next video. So this one's a short one, but I do want to still get your guys' opinion on something. We have hit 200 subscribers. Thank you guys so much. Now, I do want to do something special for you guys, but I want to see what you guys think. I am definitely going to do a gem card giveaway. I'll be picking it up here in about a week or two. I'll be picking up the 2,500 gems, so about $20 worth of gems. It'll be through the... I'll pick the winner, I'll scratch off the code, and I'll send the code to one lucky winner. The other thing I want to know, do you guys want to do a Google Hangout with me one day? So one day, we probably jump on YouTube or Twitch, I'll stream the entire thing, just me, you guys, the subs, or anyone watching, just talking, bullshitting. If you guys want to run dungeons with me, I'll run dungeons with you. If you guys want to try and raid, that may be a bad idea, but I'll try and raid if you want to PvP. Keep in mind, I am horrendous at PvP, but I'll try and jump in there with you guys. It's just a way that, hey, you guys have watched my content, and I thank you so much for it. I kind of want to give back, and that's one of the easiest ways I can think to give back. I also want to meet, you guys. I really do. I don't go to conventions, stuff like that. I am working a, piss poor 9-to-5 job right now. I actually just started a new job, last October. So I'm still working my way up to getting to a decent wage. But I do want to hang out with you guys. You guys make me want to do this. So I thought, hey, let's hang out with you guys, see what you think, see if there's any videos you guys want me to make in my style, because I know my style, while very noobish, is a bit different from other people's. I do have another video idea in mind. I do want to make a char lore video, like I did with the human gods a while ago, and I may even do one for every race if you guys think that's cool. Other than that, please, please, please let me know down in the comments below, or tweet me at DarthChain. And let me know if you guys want to do the Google Hangout. If not, I will find a way to get the, to give away the gem card, and I'll just give it away and go from there. I would love to do a Google Hangout because I have met a few of my subs in game, and I just think it is the coolest thing to see. So if you guys do want to do the Hangout, please let me know. I'd love to do it, but I'm only going to do it if people are interested and will actually show up. Other than that, do take care. We'll see you guys in the next one, which is going to be Gorseval himself. Now I'm going to do both ways to do Gorseval. I'll probably splice the video in half because I do have footage of a non-updraft run and one of a updraft run. So I'll probably splice them together instead of doing it like I did the fractal ones where I did one specific path, then the other specific path kind of put into one like with Underground. So I can explain the mechanics for both options in one video. Other than that, you guys, do take care. We will see you in the next one. And again, let me know how you guys, if you guys want to do the hangout or not, down below. Later.